Muscle Whisperer. Characteristics of successful massage therapists. Many people start working in a spa or hotel. This provides lots of hands-on experience without having to sell yourself or risk starting a business. If the work situation is tolerable or supportive enough, some people stay in the situation throughout their professional life. These notes are written for people who are self-employed and therefore have to take care of the business side and find their own clients. It covers what I think are the essential areas that practitioners need to address. Many of us are initially weak in some of these areas. I think most people can, with help, develop themselves in the relevant areas if they're motivated. Good supervision, either one-to-one or in a group, can be an important way of doing this. Having/developing a business attitude. The ability to promote yourself, especially at the beginning of working for yourself, online, in social situations, giving presentations, encouraging clients to recommend others, etc. Being clear about money, what your prices need to be, not undercutting yourself. Working out and cultivating the type of clientele that you want to work with, for example, sports people, stressed office workers, the elderly, people with learning disabilities, people recovering from illnesses or in hospices. Having the ability to engage with people, having a good bedside manner, not just massage skills. Shy people, for example, need to develop a more outgoing aspect of their personality for meeting people and selling themselves. I have also seen people fail professionally who had considerable massage training, but were cold and distant towards people. Because massage is such a demanding activity, only a proportion of people make it their full-time activity. Over time, these people may change their style of working to maintain their career. For example, by incorporating less hand-intensive techniques, such as learning to work hands-free, using the forearm and elbow skillfully, and using techniques such as muscle energy technique, which actively involve clients more. And as they get older, many people choose to work with a less physically demanding clientele. For example, by doing massages that focus more on relaxation and pampering and doing less sports massage. Many people only do massage part-time. Some massage practitioners offer other hands-on treatments as well, such as aromatherapy or reflexology, to broaden their potential client base. Some people teach classes such as sports, exercise, fitness, relaxation, stress management, or yoga, which can develop complementary skills and can also be a source of new massage clients. Many people do other related activities, such as teaching massage, selling massage or exercise products, or running a spa or health center. And some people do another totally unrelated job part-time alongside their part-time massage practice. Developing massage skills. Being interested in skills development, learning, practicing, and incorporating new techniques, and working over time to make them your own. Most of us start with similar basic training. Developing your range of skills and your unique blend makes you more attractive in the marketplace. This also keeps your massage practice alive and fresh for you, rather than it becoming a boring, stultifying routine. Ability to adapt to client needs and demands, tailoring each massage to the individual. I had a regular client with MS who I just stroked. Anything firmer stirred up his condition. By contrast, I had a very strong builder who was also a weekend sports person. He needed me to be working deeply into his muscles within a few minutes. However, on one occasion, he arrived in great pain, having overdone it on the weekend. At first, all I could do for him on the table was gentle, slow stretches of his muscles, until he relaxed enough by the end of the session that I could add some pressure to the stretches. Nourishing yourself. There's great potential for burnout in massage. Giving to your clients physically, mentally, and perhaps emotionally as well, and forgetting to be sure to replenish your own energy. You can refresh yourself professionally through attending conferences and workshops, and via supervision, in a group, one-to-one, or by any regular support time with colleagues. It's important to have other interests outside of massage. Interests, hobbies, activities, family life. And many people build in regular activities to nourish mind, body and spirit, such as sports, gym sessions, martial arts, yoga, meditation, spiritual practices, time out, pampering, time in nature.